The world of picking a GPU has changed. There was a time when GPUs were just scarce, and understanding value when it came to GPUs was conflated just with the fact that you couldn't actually get your hands on one. It was a world in which you just took what you could get, and it's almost like value didn't matter because you just wanted to put a dumb GPU inside of your system. Well, now that things have settled, those false paradigms on value, especially when it's talking about comparing GPUs against one another, and what is the best GPU for the money, well, those still remain. As does my use of fancy vocabulary words like paradigm, word of the day calendars for the win. Well, today, guys, we're gonna fix that. Today, we're gonna set the record straight on what value and performance really means when it comes to modern day GPUs. It's a brave new world out there for new GPU shoppers. We don't have to buy cards that have been used and abused for mining because that was scary. And now that things have come back to earth on the GPU front, there are some things that we just need to help here at Robeytech clarify what's truly the best GPU for the money, especially when it comes to 1080p, 1440p, and finally 4K. See, with the new AMD Radeon 7000 series and the equally as new 40 series dominating the social media ecosphere, there's a bit of confusion on if the Radeon 6000 series cards are even relevant and where they stand as potential purchase options if you want to get into PC gaming. Here's a spoiler alert, they are absolutely relevant and their performance for what you pay is crazy. There was an old rule of thumb that if you got a 6600 series card, it matched up with the 60 series from the competition. And kind of the same thing for the 6700 XT. It would match up with the 70 series and so forth. And when things were crazy, people thought that was true. But if you really look at it, that wasn't true for either price or performance. But let's take a moment and consume all of these 6000 series graphics cards properly. And instead of going all crazy and looking at each card individually and you hanging out in this video for like 3 hours, we're gonna do some magic and categorize them into resolutions. No. Not New Year's resolutions, video resolutions, more specifically 1080p, 1440p, and 4K. So let's start off with 1080p. There are four cards in the Radeon stack that are really targeted for great performance at 1080p and at a great price. These are the Radeon 6400 XT, 6500 XT, 6600 XT, and 6650 XT. 1080p is where a lot of new PC gamers are jumping into gaming on the PC for the first time. And they're looking to maximize their budget for those FPS titles they love, like Fortnite, Call of Duty, Valorant, and Apex Legends. You want to ensure that you are getting the best bang for your buck, and lucky for you, these four cards from AMD fit into that category perfectly. What if you had a bit more room in your budget for the entire PC, looking to spend around $1,000? Well, that's where these two graphics cards from AMD are really ready to step in, the 6600 XT and the 6650 XT. My favorite? Is the 6650 XT, and when you compare the 6650 XT against the equally priced 30 series entry-level card in a smattering of games, well, the data is pretty clear. These charts and graphs are the no-frills, raw gameplay, meaning neither card is getting any added benefit, like super sampling, etc. This is just all things being equal, and in our testing, you get a fantastic 1080p experience with the Radeon 6650 XT. That's playing all of your games at ultra settings at 1080p or playing your competitive FPS titles at frame rates that are great for high refresh rate monitors like 120 hertz or 144 hertz. And that's doing that while enjoying life on a sub $1,000 gaming PC. Now, let's talk about 1440p. 1440p is turning into that larger sweet spot for gaming. In many ways, it's the new 1080p. You double the pixels, textures look crisper, games just look better. AMD still has some great GPUs that are still cost effective, and those are the 6700 XT, 6750 XT, and even the 6800, which the 6800 not only crushes at 1440p, but you can also look at some potential gaming at 4K. Let's break it down with another one of those beautiful graphs, shall we? Again, impressive numbers all around, and numbers anyone would be happy with. Well, outside of that entry-level 30 series card on the graph, that seems a little low for the price that you pay. Guys, we compared each card with their direct counterpart from the competition, and the Radeon cards not only took the lead in value, but also in all but one particular game, Radeon had the advantage when it came to performance. Even when you look at AMD's much larger pool of data, you can see that the uplift is almost identical to what we found in our testing. You're seeing an average of about 19% uplift on all 1440p cards. It's just hard to justify any of the 30 series cards when you're paying more money for less performance across the board. Okay, so final category, 4K. And this is for you aficionados who aren't trying to break the bank, but also want to play some of the latest blockbuster titles at 4K resolution with the graphical fidelity you've come to expect. For you, AMD has two great Radeon cards at very competitive prices, the 6800 XT and 6950 XT. And when you stack the two cards up against the 30 series competition, spoiler alert, these two Radeon cards are punching well above what the best team green has to offer at the same price range. Now, it may seem like I'm harping on the 30 series cards, but guys, when you look at the cost of the 6000 series cards and the cost of the 30 series cards, and you clump them together based on cost, and then you look at the performance delta, which isn't small, guys, there's no malice here. We're just looking at data. So yeah, again, the numbers are pretty clearly in Team Red's favor. And there isn't any weird data here, it's just raw FPS numbers for games at the same resolution and the same graphical setting. So, blowing this out once more, when you look at the larger pool of games that AMD tested, both for the 6800 XT and the 6950 XT, you can clearly see that you're getting more FPS for less money. But again, it's not just in 4K, like this top quality graph we just got finished razzle-dazzling you with, but also in 1080p and at 1440p. There really isn't a way to frame it where the Radeon 6000 series cards don't look like the better value across the stack at each of these resolutions when comparing both price and performance. Not to mention one of the other benefits of Team Red here is the amount of VRAM on the graphics cards. Here, look at this. With modern games, like for instance Hogwarts Legacy, you can see that this game is using 10 gigabytes of VRAM running around Hogsmeade at 1440p, something any of the 1440p Radeon cards can manage easily given the ample amount of VRAM AMD has provided. But over on the competition, well, this becomes a problem. It bottlenecks the performance, and the issue only grows as you're jumping up in resolutions like 4K. Simply put, bottlenecking is bad, and many modern day titles like Resident Evil 4 are requiring more VRAM. Just something worth keeping in mind when you're shopping for a GPU. We covered an awful lot in this video, and we showed a lot of data, but I want to wrap this up into a nice little bow. I think a lot of how folks compared cards from the past, in the dark times, when GPUs were scarce, it needs to be reevaluated. When you look at how these cards stack up, when it comes to the cost, it's hard to argue, given all the performance data I've just covered with you, that there just isn't more value in not only the performance of the different 6000 series cards at 1080p, 1440p, and 4K, but also at just how much more you get for the money you spend. This guide is about helping you make your dollar stretch, and no matter where you fit on the spectrum, as a person looking to get into gaming for the first time on a very strict budget, all the way up to the enthusiast looking to build that cost-effective 4K gaming rig. It's time to take a good, hard look and really see what you're getting for your money. So, if you see something that tickles your fancy, check down below. There's a page link with all of these cards listed for you. And hopefully, with the help of this guide, you feel a whole lot more educated to find something that's really gonna work for you.